doing? My name's Renardo Hall here at Jones Technical Institute. Tonight, I'm performing how you would operate an overhead crane. This is J-Tex overhead crane. But basically, what we're going to be doing is going over the safety features and also just in general how to operate. Okay? It's pretty much straightforward. How it operates. Up, down, okay, going to the left, going to the right. This right here, that's a stop switch. It's spring loaded. When it comes down, you cannot operate this thing. So it will be that will stop it, but you still got power going to it from the switch. Wherever the switch is located, you got two switches to it. If that power switch is off, there's only two that can cut power from it. This cuts power from it as an emergency stop. So we expect those to make sure those are working. We also expect our actual hook here, a hoist. And we want to make sure there's not damage. We want to make sure that we know what load, how much our load is. Can it hold that load? In this situation, it can. Say it holds 7.5. That does not weigh 7.5. So, you know, we know that it can pull it up. We're checking this cable here for frame and probing. That, if that's the case, man, that's out of service. That needs to be replaced.
Yeah.
So, what I'm going to be doing is going through the controls, showing you how to operate. Also, what we want to be checking as well, too, is the voice over. It's supposed to be a limiter. When it goes up, it's supposed to stop before it get all the way to the top. When it goes down, it's going to be a certain spot, it's going to stop to go through that show you. Right now, I'm going to go ahead and operate, it's going to go up. As you can see, it's going up, I'm pressing it up, going up. While we got it right here, midway in the air, I'm going to go ahead and shoot it to the left. You see up there, that's what's moving. Go ahead and shift it to the right. Getting a dusty wind in there, too, so you know, that's why I'm here after what it comes. Basically, what I'm doing now is talking about that limiter that I was talking about earlier. Ahead and stop. I didn't do that. And stop. I won't go anymore. That's what it's supposed to do. That's a safety mechanism. So now we're going to go ahead and go come down and see what it does when we bring it all the way down. Keep my finger on there. See what it's doing. This will fail the inspection because it's not supposed to be done. Also, we want to, as I mentioned about the load capacity, we're supposed to know what the load capacity is. Also, somewhere on it, it will tell you what holds up there on the actual frame, set 200 frame. You see up there, EMAC 072. It goes from left and right, too. It's supposed to be a limiter. Going down, I'll continue to press. I'm gonna take it off that wheel. Thank you. uno toppa. Supposed to start somewhere along the net. See, I just stopped that. So look at that. It's continuing to go down. It's not supposed to do that. That's out of service. We out in the field and we do that. We cannot use this thing. You got to be operating in the same manner. This thing can live several times. Like, you really want this thing to be up there where it can't operate properly? Maybe should be going that way. It goes left and it goes right. It's supposed to be the exact same thing. It's supposed to have that liminal switch. Continue to go. Continue to win. All right, that was how to go through the overhead crank. I'm Bernardo Hall here at Jones Technical Institute. Thank you, Bernardo.